Holy cow, stick around and find out what we got ourselves into.
Compro, what are you doing?
I'm prepared for our crew. Oh, we're gonna sail to Madagascar, so not sure the weather is good for cooking, so I just prepare before.
Are you excited? Nervous?
Right now, I'm busy.
Okay, fair enough. Before you can go across the ocean, you need to de-skin the chickpeas. So Kun Kale and I are taking care of the serious business. We're also teaching each other different languages. I'm learning some Thai. She's learning some English. We know how to say cafe, nom, nam tan, nam.
We have just pulled out of the marina of Eden in the Seychelles, and we are moving out to head to Madagascar. Seychelles Port Authority, Proud Cat, over. Yes, sir, I just wanted to notify you that we are checked out of the country and we are on our way to Madagascar. Proud Cat, standing by 1-6.
So is it your experience as a pilot that you're able to understand what they're saying over the radio?
Helps a lot.
So we are just getting started on our trip from the Seychelles to Madagascar, and it is already really rough out here. And I do not have my sea legs back yet. As you can see, our ladies prepared us some amazing food, prepared so we can just smack it together real fast when we are on the rough seas and nobody feels like spending too much time in the kitchen. It'll be a long 5 days. Roy Mak Mak. That means fucking delicious.
Alright, well, we are headed out. It's kind of rough out here. We got 18 knots of headwind. The crew has been on land a little too long. As you can see, they are out. But they're going to get rousted here in a little bit because we're going to put up the main and launch some sails and go sailing.
Is going to be a lot of vomit the next few days.
Well, things have been a little rough. We're maybe 10 nautical miles out to sea, and it has not been nice, but we are sails up, and we are rocking along at about 7 knots. We've got cross waves and rough water. And I was gonna make this wonderful report because everybody else is sick, and I felt great, and I went down to get my phone and I came back up and holy shit, I filled a bucket up all the way. I can't even look at myself doing this selfie stuff here. Handsome dude.
As the sun set, Team Proudcat questioned what they had gotten themselves into. I woke up to the nav lights being off and the AIS is also off. My only conclusion with that is that we're worried about pirates. It makes me worry about crashing into another vessel because we're basically invisible out here. It's pitch black. And the whole crew spent the first day just throwing up into buckets and questioning their life choices. So, day two.
Kuntam Arai. Kun Rusik, okay?
Okay, ha.
Mami Maura?
Mami Maura.
Mami Maura.
Mami Maura, ha.
Okay. Everybody else on the boat is Maura, but Kun Kel is the champion.
I'm just get up to do my shift in the morning. After I tore it up all day and all night, still not feel good, but I'm just trying to be normal because we have a long way to go.
Wow. 15,000 miles of ocean crossing since we've left Singapore. And holy cow. Holy shit, just a minute. You know, when you're seasick, it's not like I want to go home. It's not like I want to go back. It's like I want to die.
I just want to die.
Many sailors have told me this may be the worst stretch in the next 60,000 miles, so let's get it behind us.
Got a pretty bad headache, probably from being dehydrated. It's hard to drink enough water when even water makes you feel like you're gonna vomit. But I did see some dolphins.
Puppy has no mercy, huh? Has not let up. How you feeling? How you feeling?
Holy shit, this is how I feel.
Day 3. I just had some breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The past 3 days, I think I've had 2 or 3 apples. Can't hold anything else down. I don't know if anyone else is even eating. I don't see anybody else. Everybody's just always either sleeping, vomiting, or at the helm. It's pretty fucking miserable.
Well, feeling a little better tonight than I was last night, but I am rather surprised how sick I have been. Pushing apparent wind speeds in 30 knots, true wind speeds in about 25 knots. Everybody's safe. The boat's doing well. A few more days and we should be out of this. Goon Prow is not so encouraged when I say a few more days.
It really sounds like the boat is just gonna rip apart and we're all gonna die. And I just wish that we would have died on the first day instead of going through this.
Hey guys, I just discovered this amazing new diet that I need to tell you all about. It's pretty incredible. You need to kick off that extra 10 kilos by this weekend. I got the plan for you. It's called the Indian Ocean Sailing Diet. Get a yacht. Sail the Indian Ocean. You won't want to eat. If you do eat, you will throw up. You'll be looking so slim and fit. Back on land, I eat 3 meals a day like some type of fat ass. But out on the Indian Ocean diet, I eat 1 apple a day. Today was my cheat day, so I had 1 apple and 3 potato chips. There's a good chance I'm gonna throw that back up. Watch the pounds, those love handles, and your sanity disappear within days. It's a lot rougher than it looks, trust me.
I feel like I want to die. I just want to die. I don't know. I wish we not by the boat in this water. I just wanna die. I just cannot eat. I don't have power. I feel like I'm selfish. Oh my, I'm sorry. I just don't know how to make it better. Keep it right up. can I stop?
Some eggs. It's gonna be my first meal. The intention of keeping it in my stomach. Bon appetit.
Hey, look, we're not the only ones dumb enough to be out here. Another vessel.
A lot better today, I must say. I had 2 eggs a second ago, and now I'm pushing it. I'm gonna eat an orange as well, get some of that weight back that I lost. It's called the Indian Ocean Sailing Diet, and I must credit a lot of my success right now, my health and my lack of seasickness, to these noise canceling headphones that Captain Mike let me borrow. Game changer, you know. I'm listening to music, listening to books on tape. And it's just, it changes the element. You get rid of all that wind noise, and it's just like, I'm in my zone. Wow. I'm gonna definitely buy a pair. I'm hoping the sea will reward me with some dolphins, or actually what I really wanna see is a big-ass whale just come up right on the side of the boat and scare the shit out of me, you know? Just any type of whale, I don't know. Just something big. So I just got out of my cabin. I did an 8-hour shift today. And then I come upstairs to find some tape. And what do I see? Asleep. Asleep. And nobody at the helm. Really responsible, guys.
And then when we thought we could take it no longer, we saw a beautiful sight. Land. It's fucking land.
We are home run stretch, man. 40 nautical miles, and we are going to meet Dale and Eric. But we are inside the lee of Madagascar, and the wind is still 20 knots of true wind speed, and we got 20 meters of depth. So we're rocking across the shelf.
Well, after a very long 27... Oh, after a very long 5 days, we finally see Madagascar and smooth waters, which is just amazing. Unfortunately, not everybody survived.
A lot of my fish die of the topic.
Rest in peace, little guy.
Arriving in the new country, Mike hung the yellow flag.
To represent no disease or no act of war.
I think it means I'm not checked in yet.
Smash that like button, hit the subscribe, and turn on the notification bell to come back next time to see if we want to put the boat on the market or if it was all worth it.